Every fight is different, feels different. It's its own journey.
For me, all my life is martial arts.
I know 100% my next fight is going to be the best fight of my career.
I've been top 10 in the world for 10 years. I think a lot of people forget that.
I took 2 steps back to take 10 steps forward.
Being from Hawaii, fighting is just in my DNA.
I already know I lost the belt. The only thing to make that feel better is the victory.
I'm training hard. The main goal is the belt.
Any day of the week, I could possibly be champ, and I want to prove it.
That's my time. Nobody can stop me. Nobody.
I really like punching somebody in the face. I'm like a little beast.
The goal is always the same, is to go out there and beat an ass.
El sábado 23 de julio, 6 de los más talentosos artistas marciales mixtos del mundo coincidirán en la Ciudad de los Vientos para poner en juego sus deseos de campeonato y sus sueños en vivo en UFC Fight Night. El emocionante evento principal de la noche a 5 asaltos presenta a 2 de las más premiadas pegadoras en la historia de las artes marciales mixtas. Cuando la 18 veces campeona mundial de boxeo Holly Holm, quien en noviembre de 2015 se apropió del cinturón de las pesos gallo de UFC de manera inolvidable. Se enfrenta a Valentina Shevchenko, una de las mejores practicantes de Muay Thai del planeta.
Valentina Shevchenko.
En un segundo enfrentamiento de alto octanaje, 2 ligeros con calibre de campeones chocan cuando el espectacular Edson Barboza busque cimentar su búsqueda de un título de UFC con otra demostración característica. Contra el durante largo tiempo campeón de Strikeforce y 2 veces retador al título ligero de UFC, Gilbert Melendez. Y en un emocionante tercer combate, la favorita local Felice Herrick buscará desplegar su estelar golpeo y peligroso juego a ras de la lona contra la fenómeno de 25 años Kaylin Curran, la primera peleadora femenina de UFC venida de Hawái. Para cada artista marcial mixto de clase mundial, su misión empieza con uno de los más exigentes y agotadores caminos de todos los deportes, The Road to the Octagon. Siempre se ha sabido que, sorprendentemente, el camino a la fama de una de las más grandes estrellas de los deportes de combate empezó hace casi 2 décadas atrás, cuando, por puro capricho, tomó una clase de kickboxing en su ciudad.
You know, you can look back at your life and think about how one path just made the whole difference on what your future was.
Holly walked in the gym 17 years ago or so. She was a blank piece of clay. Showed her how to throw her first punch. You could tell right away she was a fighter.
So many people start, they love to fight, but they're trying to find the right trainer. They're trying to find the right gym. I walked into the right gym, and I've never had to leave.
En una transición sin costuras del boxeo a las artes marciales mixtas, Holly Holm empezó su carrera en este deporte con 9 victorias corridas, producto de asombrosas combinaciones y poder con precisión. Entonces, el pasado noviembre destronó a Ronda Rousey con una patada a la cabeza que se escuchó en todo el mundo. Tres meses y medio después, en su primera defensa del título, Holm parecía estar en camino hacia una victoria decisiva sobre Miesha Tate, antes de que dejara su guardia baja para el 5º y último asalto. Hoy, Holm quizás guarde remordimientos, pero escoger defender su título rápidamente no es uno de ellos.
The biggest thing was, oh, Holly should have waited for the rematch with Ronda. Here's my question for all of those people. We still don't know when Ronda's coming back, so I'd still be sitting. Technically, I'd be sitting with the belt right now, but is there any satisfaction in that? Yeah, it ran me into a loss, but I don't regret saying I wanted the fight. But at the end of the day, now who's next?
After the Miesha fight, you can't get her to stop. You have to pull back on the reins a little bit. She'll work out endlessly all day long, every day. The guys around here don't want to go running with her in the mountains because they know that's going to suck. They're going to try to keep up with her. She's going to keep going. She's going to call them names. She's very competitive that way.
Para la ex campeona de las pesos gallo, el fuego competitivo no es nada nuevo. Y el lugar donde nació ese fuego puede ubicarse justo al sur de Albuquerque, donde Holm creció como la menor de tres, practicando soccer, gimnasia y más.
Ever since she was small, whatever she wanted to do, she would just like get really focused and do it. Having two older brothers did make her push herself and want to do what they did and want to do it as good as them. You know, they'd go back and run on the ditch banks and ride bikes on the ditch banks and build tree houses and climb trees.
I think I learned a lot of that from her. I mean, she's out doing archery and bow hunting and fishing.
I'm competitive with my archery. I absolutely love that, but I have competitiveness kind of rise in other ways. I do think she gets that from me.
My mom went to four pro fights. She didn't really like, you know, it's intense emotion. She would always get worked up, didn't really want to necessarily be there for the fight.
What I tell people is that there's nowhere that it's written in order to be a good mom that you have to watch your daughter fight. But I did massage therapy for 25 years. I kept her body up. I may not be ringside, but I'm still mom. I want to be mom. And I like to be her place kind of away from everything.
The main goal is the belt, the champion of bantamweight female division.
El campamento de entrenamiento de la oponente de Hall, Valentina Shevchenko, se encuentra a orillas del Golfo, donde a medio camino de su nativo Kirguistán se reúne con su amiga más cercana y también peleadora, su hermana Antonina.
Small, I think it will be small for me.
Yellow with the flowers.
No.
I started martial arts since 5 years old.
I definitely like this style.
My mom, she is black belt of Taekwondo and president of Kyrgyz Muay Thai Federation.
I think I will try everything and then decide.
So it was tradition in my family. Antonina, she is older than me, and she started to practice martial arts before me.
I like the way.
It's okay for you, this role was the top.
I like it.
She's world champion 8 times. When I was a child, she was for me an example. What I should be in the home for me, example, in the training, example.
If it's good, better, we need to swing.
She supported me every time. And every monument and every part of my life, she is here. When I see her victory, I'm feeling like I win the fight. And I can say the same, when I win the fight, she like feeling it's her victory. That's why I'm very happy to have this person in my life.
Los sobrenombres de las hermanas, Panther y Bullet, hablan claro acerca del talento para la lucha en su familia. Y mientras Antonina puede ser una 8 veces campeona mundial de Muay Thai, su hermana menor ha ganado 17 campeonatos combinados en kickboxing y Muay Thai. Y cuando Valentina hizo su debut en UFC el pasado diciembre ante la ex campeona de Strikeforce, Sarah Kaufman, inmediatamente puso la división sobre aviso. Entonces, en marzo, con la potencial oportunidad de una pelea por el cinturón de UFC en juego, la rápida y precisa peleadora casi derrotó a Amanda Nunes. Y aunque esa apretada decisión últimamente le dio la oportunidad a Nunes para que luego alcanzara el cinturón, Shevchenko reanudó sus entrenamientos con más hambre que nunca. Y la peleadora rusa dejó de lado el gimnasio para entrenar a cielo abierto en la improbablemente llamada Moscú, Texas.
Outdoor training is a very big part of our process of training.
Poco más. 10 segundos más, vamos.
Me, my sister, our coach, Pan Fedotov, is going to be training all our life. We travel around the world, looking different places. All nature, it's perfect. It's air, it's spirit of nature, it's everything together. In every place, I use this energy what I have in this place. It's helped put me in condition like a little bit more wild, maybe. It's better to say like this. What sometimes it's very useful for fights.
Poco descansamos y seguimos con árboles. cada nueva técnica que puede hacer Antonina mejor, en 2-3 meses lo mismo hace Valentina, y al revés. Entonces es más fácil entrenar, porque este intercambio apoya para los dos crecer rápido.
We look up to each other. We always support each other when we had fights, because Valentina is a great fighter, very dedicated fighter, very focused fighter.
It's a sports competition. For example, swimming faster than me, I'll try to be better and follow her steps.
I feel that in my training I go forward. The main goal is the belt.
She understands how important this fight for her. She's like very focused, very focused.
Valentina es peleadora completa. Holly Holm pelea parado de distancia. Por eso Valentina necesita implicar todas sus oportunidades y todas sus artes para ganar esta pelea.
Good team, very strong team. This is a result of work all team. This is what is success.
Siete meses atrás, luego de que Holly Holm derrotara a Ronda Rousey para convertirse en campeona de UFC, más de 20.000 fans acudieron a su desfile de la victoria.
My career started here. My fans started here. My whole career started right here, and it wasn't just my team that helped me believe in myself, but it was the support of Albuquerque, and I just thank you so much for taking the time.
Y esa victoria sísmica de Holm resuena aún hoy.
She went from being a local Albuquerque, New Mexico celebrity to worldwide. She met Jay-Z and Beyonce, Dave Chappelle. We went to the basketball game with Jamie Foxx. All these humongous stars are just wanting to meet Holly. You know, we used to, you know, joke about it before. It's like, when we go on a vacation, we'll go to Colorado. We'll go to California and get away from it. It's not the case anymore.
Y mientras Holm se alista para encabezar el cartel de UFC Fight Night en Chicago, se encuentra una vez más bajo los reflectores.
Look who just walked in.
Oh my God.
No, it's us. That's your God?
Yes, Holly Holm is my God.
Oh my God.
Life has changed a lot. A lot of the demands on what people want. You know what? I lost the belt. Fair and square. You know, I never thought like to be a household name. You know, that people across the world will say my name while they're talking about the fight at dinner or something. Weird to me.
Let's talk about the other fight. Obviously, you're known for taking care of Ronda Rousey, the first person to do that in the UFC.
You know, it's going to go down as one of the greatest upsets or victories in history. We didn't think it was an upset, but the general public did.
Holly is in studio with us here on SBL.
No, Holly, though, she's really grounded. It's not the money, it's not the fame. She's still a little girl from New Mexico.
So it is a lot of weight to carry, but it's in a good, positive way. And it just drives me to want to be better and to keep improving. And onward to victory all the time, you know?
Desde el principio, un hombre ha estado siempre al lado de The Preacher's Daughter, en sus picos y sus valles. El propio predicador.
That moment, the fight's over, a victory, you did something that nobody thought you could do. Then I look over and I see my family. You can't express and you can't explain what those feelings are.
It was a big mountain in a lot of ways, just psychologically. That joy when we were jumping up and down there, and that had both relief and joy tied in together.
We seem to forget that we have all of this power behind us and given to us because we trust in God.
He worked my corner through my whole boxing career, but he never actually gave the advice. He'd put the stool in, be there. It was kind of more of that moral and spiritual support for me. It just always made me feel very comfortable to have him there.
I always looked at it from a little different angle. There's fight in every one of us. I think people love competitive sports so much because it gives them a quick picture of how life can turn out, sometimes in a victory and sometimes in a humiliating defeat. It gives you a real test of your resiliency and your ability to bounce back, and do you really want to?
I've been the champ and had to retain it. It was like there, I had it. And I lost focus. The only thing to make that feel better is the victory. That's the only cure for the sickness, you know?
She knows that you gotta get to this young lady first before she gets back to the title.
I have my hands full. I'm a very different style of fighter than Misha, than Rhonda. And I'll tell you, some of the toughest fighters come out of Muay Thai.
Go! Where's your trip? Beautiful! Beautiful!
I think true champions, really, they learn from their defeat and it makes them better. Holly had the devastating knockout in boxing, and the first thing she wanted to do was get back out there and rematch her and get her title back. And she did.
I'm not going for a participation ribbon to say I made it through it. I'm going for the gold. I want to dominate.
Para prepararse para Holly Holm, inicialmente Valentina Shevchenko empezó a entrenar en Perú. Sin embargo, para ella y su entrenador Pavel Fedotov, el destino intervino.
Before I came to Houston, we was right few weeks in Peru. Next day, we waited Antonina from World Championship from Sweden. We were spending the night, have dinner with our friends. And then in the second, I see the robbers coming to the restaurant. That moment I was thinking, no, it cannot be right here, right now, no. Pavel was thinking about my safety to hide me. It happened so fast. I didn't have any time to think about this. When I saw Pavel on the floor and I saw this, he's injured, it was very, very clear. I need to be there and I need to help.
Luego de proteger a su peleadora, el entrenador Pavel Fedotov encaró a los ladrones. Pero mientras escapaban, recibió un tiro y Shevchenko se apresuró a atenderlo.
They was very close, even then other person in the restaurant said the robbers came back. So we went to the street, take the taxi and go to emergency. It's affect my training. It's affect my mental condition. I should think about only my training, about concentration, but I could not because I was very preoccupied about the health of Pavel. When it's like past and we are here every minute, I feel recovering. I am very happy that they are both together with me. This gives me power to keep forward with more strength, more energy. I will go and take it.
Con su entrenador de regreso a su lado, Shevchenko busca ahora dejar atrás el robo a mano armada y el tiroteo y enfocarse en la tarea que tiene enfrente.
I love not only fight, but I love all process to be in the fight. I like to feel this training. I like to feel every moment of my preparation. I like to feel calm and then explosion. Holly, she has good legs, good boxing. I am many times world champion of Muay Thai, so I think it will be very interesting striking fight. Valentina has everything to win this fight.
Backfist, salto de puño, patadas de giro, y por eso ella puede ganar en cualquier manera.
The main goal is the belt, the champion of bantamweight female division. At the top of the world. I understand how important it is for my career, and I will dictate the fight and finish the fight fast. Good day for me.
Every time I think about this fight, I think about war.
And it's about who wants it more in this fight. And my goal is to break this guy.
If I didn't truly want this, I wouldn't be doing it. I wouldn't come this far.
I'm a fighter. Through and through, I'll do whatever it takes.
Hace 34 años, en California, nació un peleador conocido como El Niño, que se convertiría en uno de los más grandes pesos ligeros de su era.
You visualize your career, and I visualized it so many times. You reach goals, you have to find a way to motivate yourself or just to get out there and do it. For once in my life, I don't need to fight, but I still want to fight. You know, once I realized that, that made me feel really good. I want to fight, you know, I could run away, I could walk away right now, but why? I've been top 10 in the world for 10 years. I've been pound for pound for a few years. And I think a lot of people forget that. I'm still relevant in this sport, and I want to prove it.
En 2006, Gilbert Melendez ingresó a Strikeforce con un récord invicto y continuaría para conseguir victorias en 9 peleas titulares y dejar la organización como el más grande campeón que hubiera conocido. En 2013, Melendez hizo su muy anticipado debut en el octágono, donde casi destronó al entonces campeón Benson Henderson en una duramente peleada decisión. Solo 6 meses más tarde, Melendez regresaría al terreno de prueba final para ganar una épica batalla contra Diego Sánchez en una de las mejores peleas en la historia de UFC. Sin embargo, la oportunidad titular que se ganó con ese desempeño épico terminó rápidamente. Y entonces, un año después, enfrentó un revés aún mayor cuando fue suspendido por 12 meses por violar el código de conducta del peleador de UFC.
This year's been ups and downs. Initially, it was a little rough. Recognizing how many people support you and love you is a beautiful thing. And I'm supported, I'm loved, I'm blessed by my family, my friends, my community at the El Niño Training Center, and my real fans.
Gilbert having some time away was, I think it was a good thing for us. And for him, I saw Gilbert be able to take a mental break.
You know, you gotta look at the glass half full, not half empty. And I try to make the best out of the situation. You know, it was my time to reinvent myself. I'm a father, I'm a gym owner, I opened up a fight shop, I'm an analyst, I'm traveling, and of course, number one, I'm a fighter.
Melendez pelea para un equipo llamado Scrap Pack, un equipo que Gilbert cofundó a principios de 2008, y cuyos más famosos y notorios miembros, Nate y Nick Diaz, residen en Lodi, 145 kilómetros al este.
Our team is known as all these guys are tough. These guys are go-getters, you know, but I think we stand for something else more than that. We stand for loyalty, stand for a brotherhood, we stand for family.
Got nothing but good things to say about Gilbert. He's somebody I look up to for a long time. When he's on point, he's one of the best fighters that I've ever trained with. He is the best at the weight division I've ever trained with. When he wins, I win. So I do whatever I can. I'm on call when he's fighting. And vice versa, he's always there for me.
Sometimes the team is down and out, and then we go on a roll. You know, we've been quiet lately. And then all of a sudden, Nate Diaz beats Conor McGregor.
That's it! He's got the shot!
Nate Diaz!
He's up!
He's up! Done it!
He's up!
It is all over! Nate Diaz beats Conor McGregor!
You can't help but get excited. You can't help but get motivated. Something like Nate's victory, you know, leads me to believe I can do it. I can do this. We can do this. You know, he's doing it. That's my teammate.
I think that he's the better fighter, the more experienced fighter. Not that Barboza is not great, but it's going to be a tough fight, and it's going to be a great show for everybody to watch.
En la costa opuesta, a uno de los peleadores más formidables de Brasil puede encontrársele en su ciudad adoptiva.
I fight because I love fighting. If nobody pay me to fight, I keep fighting because I'm a fighter. That's it, I'm a fighter. Right now, I have my son, him and my wife. Bruna do everything. She do everything for me. And she's cooking every day. Really good cook.
That good?
Yup.
I'm always saying that I am the father in the home. I try to do everything else to keep him focused on his training.
That's good. That's good.
I prepare the breakfast for Edson, schedule his interviews, and I work with his website for his PR. So it's hard for us, you know, especially for us that we don't have family over here.
She's my big partner. He said that to me one day. Your dream is my dream. My dream is to get best 155 in the world and get the UFC title.
We want him to be the champion. That's the big goal, to get the belt.
That's making me motivated, say, let's go. Let's go together.
Por casi 6 años, Edson Barboza ha venido acumulando victorias espectaculares dentro del octágono.
Edson Barboza has done it again.
Y tal vez su último triunfo sea el más impresionante hasta ahora. Cuando en abril desmanteló al excampeón de los pesos ligeros Anthony Pettis.
Edson Junior Barboza.
Una victoria que tiene a este versátil talento acercándose a una largamente ambicionada oportunidad titular, mientras inicia un campamento de entrenamiento con sus compañeros de equipo y también estrellas de UFC.
My team today is one of the best team in the world.
Swizzy goes on the hook. Right? You have to be real careful not to put weight on your point.
Frank is the general. He push hard every training 100% and he never stop. That's helped me a lot.
Edson's getting better everywhere. Once he believes in his wrestling, he's going to be able to take anybody he wants down. Keep him down, beat him up, submit him. You know, he could be the complete fighter.
Además del grande libra por libra Frankie Edgar, Barboza entrena junto al también peso ligero de UFC Eddie Álvarez, quien apenas una semana atrás aporreó a Rafael Dos Anjos para convertirse en el nuevo campeón de la división.
Eddie Álvarez is a tough guy. He helped me in everything, especially because he fight with Pettis and Gilbert. I fought with Pettis, my next fight's with Gilbert.
I fought them both. From what I see here and what he shows in the octagon, I feel like it's kind of a mismatch. Edson's got it, man. And I think he has yet to show it inside the octagon. Nobody in here wants to lose. Nobody.
You see that natural evolution towards a mixed martial artist, which is a well-rounded fighter. I'm looking forward to seeing his confidence turn into consistency, and that consistency turn into world-class performances, and you know, him being able to fight for the title.
That's the best support you guys have to give to me. Beat me in the training for me getting better and better and better. I know 100% my next fight is going to be the best fight of my career.
Mientras Gilbert Melendez reside en la actualidad en la ciudad de La Bahía, las raíces de su éxito pueden encontrarse casi 650 kilómetros al sur.
Family is everything. There's no one you could trust more than family, you know, and there's no one that I know that has their best interest in mind for me than my father. And I felt that from the day I was born. Trying to make him proud has been one of my goals in my life.
So we have always taught our kids to try to find something that they like. Growing up, he was never the strongest, never the fastest, but he learned that if he kept at it, that he could grow in whatever it is that he was doing. He found wrestling as something that he really liked and he had a passion for.
Y aunque no consiguió esa pasión hasta que llegó al bachillerato, el deporte terminaría por transformar definitivamente a Meléndez.
The sport of wrestling taught me everything when it came to competition. In wrestling, there's no caring anybody. It's just you. And it tells the truth. Standing at wrestling, when I got there, you know, they showed me what hard work is.
Hey, let's go, Vargas. Come on, finish that, Vargas. You're in control there. Finish.
A lot of them come in with no experience wrestling. So as Gilbert came in with no experience, just was tenacious. He was hungry. He had a desire to be somebody, and nothing was going to stop him.
He wants to be varsity next year. He wants to take your spot. Let's go.
He's one of those guys that he's every coach's dream.
They found a way to make a sacrifice to get what you want to get. Still to this day, I'm sacrificing so much to get where I want to get.
Y para Meléndez, eso significa entrenar 6 días a la semana, de 2 a 3 veces al día.
Hey, Gil, keep that tape! Keep that tape!
So we're standing on high school wrestling techniques right here. Sprint, sprint, sprint.
On the evening of July 23rd, expect to see a very prepared Gilbert Meléndez. An in-shape Gilbert Meléndez, someone who's ready to put the pressure and fight.
I am competitive. Always been that way.
This is my chance to say I still belong, and this is his chance to say that he's the new up-and-comer. I'm not gonna let that happen. I'm not gonna go away quietly. I'm gonna still keep fighting and climbing back up that ladder. It's about who wants it more in this fight. You know, and my goal is to break this guy. What you know about that?
casi 4.200 kilómetros al este, para Edson Barbosa cada día termina como empezó, con un tiempo reservado para lo que más importa.
My family is everything for me right now.
Qualquer blusa.
Quero ver papá. Aqui.
Isso aqui.
Nothing compare. Any fight, nothing.
Boy.
When I stay with this guy, the little guy, Noah. Him and my wife.
What are you trying to do? Huh? What are you trying to do? Huh?
That's definitely the best moment of my life.
MC Kick, show your kicks.
It's so fast. The time is like there. I do everything to make my son and my wife get a better life.
Yeah.
Sometimes I was coming home, I was tired, and I miss 5 minutes. Because it's so hard, because I know these 5 minutes not come back anymore. And I hope in the future my son understands I do this for him, for his future.
He wants to be the best in the world. I believe that he can be the best in the world. And his coach believes that he can be the best in the world. That's why the belt is so important for us.
That's my number one dream right now, my focus. Every time I go to gym, training hard, just think like, man, I want to be ready for war. Gilbert, it's a big name, he's been tough for a long time, really tough guy. I'm very excited, I hope it's coming hard. I'll be ready for this.
This is a weapon. This is literally a human weapon. Gil's going to be in for a long night. Or a short night. It's going to be dangerous when he finally displays what he really is capable of. This is going to be the fight where he does that.
When Edson goes in there and fights the way he just fought, Gilbert's going to get picked apart. And maybe even Edson might put him away early.
Melendez is there to war, and he's going to bring out the best in us, and that's excitement for our team. I definitely expect Edson to be champion. There's nothing less.
Right now, my dream is going to get this belt. July 23rd, I know if I go there, give me 100%, I want to win this fight.
Ready, ready, a lot.
That's my time, man. That's my time. Nobody can stop me. Nobody, bro. Nobody.
Con la playa y el surf recordándole su hogar insular, la fenómeno hawaiana de 25 años, Kailyn Curran, se alista en el Golden State para su más grande pelea hasta la fecha.
I like being in California because it keeps me on my toes.
Drive her forward. Nice. Hips forward. Give her hips down. Give her hips. Run her over. There you go. Nice.
I think there's a real maturity that's come as she's gotten a little bit older, as she's gotten more experience, as she's gone through more of these training camps, but now that she's putting that together. They've become more comfortable with being in the spotlight a little bit. Just come a long way.
Nice. Finish that. Finish that. Adjust that lock.
Slide that arm in if you can. Good. Nice.
When I turned 18, I had my first, like, fight in Maui. I won that fight. And I think from that moment on, I knew I liked this feeling. I like showing up and being the underdog and then proving everybody wrong. Like, I can fight.
Desde su debut en UFC en 2014, Kailyn Curran ha mostrado impresionante poder y agresividad de fuego rápido dentro del octágono. Su más reciente choque ante una veterana endurecida por las batallas fue su mejor desempeño hasta la fecha. Una actuación que le valió a la primera peleadora salida de Hawái su próxima prueba ante Felice Herrig.
I think that fighting is just in my DNA. Being from Hawaii, it's just a way of life. Growing up, you have to learn how to protect yourself. Being the first woman to come out of Hawaii to be in the UFC is just awesome, and it's a good feeling. It really feels like just an honor, and I was excited about it. Being here in California, I'm out of my comfort zone. I know where I came from, I know where I've been, and I know that it's just getting better for me.
El progreso de Curran es alimentado en parte por Kings MMA, el lugar que hasta hace poco fuera base de dos campeones, Rafael Dos Anjos y Fabricio Verdún.
When you're starting to come up, right, Pat's doing all the right things. Now he's going to really use this wall and push back onto it.
Chance,
training, I came to Dawson. You know, there's a lot of familiar faces and a lot of guys that fight for the UFC. So, you know, it's good to just be around them. And that energy is great in here. It's just so much fun coming in here and having, like, more than just me and another person. Get to flow with different bodies, get different feels. Like, I'm going with guys that are a little bit heavier than me.
Feel that hand up. Get your head high. Get your head high on your hips.
A lot of bodies here and a lot of champs here for me to look up to and follow the footsteps or just, you know, look up to them and see how they're training and what their lifestyle is. So it's good here at King.
You can stay there. I'll throw it back. Get some height this time. Yeah. All right, nice throw.
If I didn't truly want this, I wouldn't be doing it. I wouldn't come this far.
Go. Sprint, 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 sprint. Push, 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 push.
Being self-motivated and having that positive mindset for myself is key. And it's just going to get better from here. Taking on Felice in Chicago, her hometown where she's from, I think it's going to put a little bit more pressure on her than me because that's her territory. She's going to have to defend it.
Make that jab count.
After having this last fight and winning, I'll remember that feeling and I just want to get a win streak going, you know, because it's not fun losing. Losing sucks.
I love the Hawaiians, man, and they all got it. But Kylan, she's raw talent. I mean, this girl's got coordination.
Use those hips, just like that tire dog.
She's got everything. Really, she has the ability, and obviously she's got the desire. Athletic, strong, quick, and hungry to learn.
I think that I really just like punching somebody in the face and getting punched in the face. I know it sounds weird, but that feeling of being able to have that power over another person, I feel like I don't need to worry about anything. Just show up and do my thing.
Boom. Poco más de 2.700 kilómetros más lejos y solo una hora al noroeste del United Center, un orgulloso nativo de Illinois se alista para montar un show en la mayor arena de su estado. Una de las primeras peso paja que firmó un contrato con UFC. Felice Herrick inicialmente impresionó durante la innovadora vigésima temporada de The Ultimate Fighter, para luego hacer una declaración en su primera salida en UFC. Sin embargo, la siguiente pelea de la poderosa veterana en abril de 2015 contra la estrella ascendente Paige VanZant terminó con un duramente luchado veredicto que no la favoreció, seguido por todo un año de ausencia del octágono.
You know, I feel like my last fight, I was really burnt out because I wanted to give so much. I was so burnt out that I had nothing left to give when it came fight time. And it's actually really hard for me to talk about because I've never felt like that before in a fight. And so that's why I took so much time off from fighting. I just got to the point where I'm like, this is me, and this is what you're getting. So take it or leave it. None of that matters. And here I am, just ready to fight. I'm at a point right now where I realize that I have to be selfish. I tend to overthink things.
Me, don't get pushed into the head.
Yeah, give me 5 lifts up, out, and down.
She's in her own head. Where we're at now is getting her to not be so emotionally connected to the fight that she even puts more pressure on herself.
You could even just like, as long as I'm bringing him to the mat, it doesn't matter.
I think it's just clicking.
I'm trying to get back to what's important. Getting my mind right, being at peace, having everything I need to perform well.
Physically, she has all the gifts to be at the top in the UFC and put on great fights. She's all go. A coach's job is to be there when she's in trouble. If the coaches have a night off and not have to do anything, then it's a good night.
El 23 de julio, Herrick buscará cumplir esa tarea al defender su terreno ante Kylan Curran.
I'm just excited to fight in my hometown. It's where I started, it's where I came from. It's nice to be able to come back and share that with the people around me. I'm not really concerned about what Kaylin's thinking. Goal is always the same, to win fights.
The key to being effective is experience and really trying to just make sure this is one of those times where she realizes this is her stage.
I took 2 steps back to take 10 steps forward to get back to Felice the Fighter. I'm doing what I was put here on Earth to do.
Días, semanas y meses de trabajo afinan las habilidades de cada peleador hasta que solo les queda una prueba más: su oponente.
She looks strong, but I think I'm stronger than her. I'm faster than her. She's been gone for a year, so I feel like she's gonna have a little bit of shock.
I've had time to reset, to recharge my battery, to get centered. She's a scrappy fighter. She's, you know, a young up-and-comer, and where I'm a little more seasoned.
That's nice that you've had your experience, but now your time is done. I'm the new girl, and I'll take over.
I'm not really concerned about what Kaylin's thinking. It's a fight, and may the better woman win.
War. Every time I think about this fight, I think about war.
I'm not running from Edson Barboza. Everyone runs from that guy. I'm gonna stay in front of the center of that octagon, and I'm gonna sling some leather, dude. I'm coming to win. I'm gonna do whatever it takes to win on this fight.
Gilbert is a really tough guy. He's a big name. He's stayed in the top for a long time. I know I'm one of the best. Right now I can prove where everybody can beat anybody.
With preparation comes confidence. I'm still here and I'm still going out there. I'm fighting for respect. If I beat Edson Barboza, I'm right back in there.
Where I am right now, I will not stay for a long time because I will keep moving. I will move forward.
Lost the belt, couldn't even get the rematch. If I don't get through this one with a success, what else is promised? When those lights come on, I know that I can do it again. That's the only cure for the sickness, yeah.
She has fast movement, punches, kicks on the head. I know exactly what I need to do. I win the fight.
Pronto, el momento de la verdad llegará. Cuando la puerta del octágono se abra y UFC Fight Night encienda Chicago. En vivo, el sábado 23 de julio.